Susan Spey, Kirkwood Bay, Culvert Bay, Crew Bay, and Abadi Creek are few among other bays across Freetown, with approximately 25 to 30% of the country's population, and are faced with diverse challenges such as flooding, poor pure water facility, poor conducive community, and the likes. These habitants have plans to move away from the slum, but without the choice of relocation. Some of these residents of Culvert, who are on probation, express their experience about life in the slum.
Expect flooding from July to September at any time. The past 8 years, every rainy season, you attack eggs in Ambogbina.
Spend it greatly. Call a care every year when you get disaster with water.
What are the purpose of home Leo? A question I asked Jonathan Ali, Community Development Officer.
Well, Home Leo is a charity organization. We can a saloon for poor people in slum dwelling. Well, the first outside with the care and go to Newton, Mabron community by 4 miles. We will get a facility they would on build, and not only the housing would give them, we also they look at the livelihood, we look at water facility, we look at power, we look at livelihood, so they're able to do some businesses them. And we also they give one person, not the family, a job.
Nigel Ark, Chief Executive Officer and Founder Home Leo, evaluates the funding of the project, its concept, plans and strategies.
God gave me a really clear picture of a village in Sierra Leone and what it would look like. And the way I describe it, it's a bit like having a puzzle, but I don't know quite which next pieces of the puzzle I will get. We are a small NGO. We don't have funding. We don't have really any great benefactors, and yet God has provided this far. So we've built 56 houses, we've built 6 classrooms, and we have half a dozen businesses. We have water bagging business, we have a bakery that's all ready to go. We're buying some KKs, where the people will be able to own their own KKs after paying for it over a year as a micro business loan. We've got a garage, so if you want your car fixing, this is the place to come. You know, if we've got, and perhaps at the core of what we're doing is the brick factory. So we've got so far, and this summer or this rainy season, we're about to move the next 200 people into this village. So that's, there'll be 240 people living here who's used to a life where the water comes up to their beds in their homes, where they've lived in horrific circumstance. And this year they won't need to live in fear. And it's a picture of what we can do in this nation. So as Destiny Village grows out, you know, this village will have 350 houses in it. That's over 2,000 people. It will have a good school because it's all integrated and it's paid for by the livelihood of people and doing business, of people being employed by us. You know, the next step we're working at is building a building company.
I was born in a slum, but the slum was not born in me, says Jesse Jackson. Will such projects last and relocate slum dwellers away from the slum communities? Reporting for FTN's Top News.
The Chela Valley Junior.